The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
I'm a big fish in a small pond. Got my days free and the nights long. I create my own reality. Who I am is fine with me. As famous, as I wanna be. Who I am is fine with me. To who I am.
Okay. Hi everybody, it's Maria from What's the Story with Maria. How's it going? Okay, so we are Facebook Living. We're trying to get on here, but I want to introduce you to my guest. My first guest is Henry Kapersky.
Hello.
And he has been on the show before, so I'm going to restart this Facebook Live, but we're going to keep talking because we are on the radio. We are on armeddigitalmedia.com. which is Armed Radio, and the name of the show is What's the Story with Maria, and we go live every Tuesday. Every Tuesday, we go live at 9 p.m. Eastern. So what we're trying to do right now is get on Facebook Live. Let me keep doing this. So Henry...
You're a good multitasker.
Yes, well, I have to be. So Henry Kapersky has been on the show before, and he is a musical director. He is, he plays sax, he plays accordion. And Henry, I want you to tell us where you're from and when you got to the city. And I'm going to get us on Facebook, come hell or high water.
Good luck.
Okay.
I am from Grand Rapids, Michigan, and I moved here in 2012, January. So it's been about 6 years and 2 months.
Okay, hold on 1 second. We're going to go... We're going to try this on Facebook again. Okay, I think we're coming in. Yay, we did it. All right. Hi, everybody. It's Maria from What's the Story with Maria. How's it going? All right, so welcome to our show. We started already. We started on the radio with armeddigitalmedia.com. We are here, and we had a little Facebook issue. So it took us a while to come on, but we are here now. Yay. Kenny Holcomb has joined us. Jason Peck has joined us. Richard Kowick has joined us. Rina Krinali-Bergi has joined us. Leo Rodriguez has joined us. And I want to thank Jimmy Bell. He's our producer and engineer tonight, and he has gotten us on the radio. Thank you, Jimmy. We had a little Facebook Live situation, but we're on now. We are on now.
I'm sharing this on my page.
Okay, you share it on your page.
There we go.
Angela Noguera has joined us, and Kimberly Travis. Angela is my cousin in Boston. She was in town a few weeks ago and took me out to dinner. Thank you, Angela. She and her boyfriend, Bill, are so nice. Thank you. Diane Pickering. Hi, Diane Pickering from out in the North Shore of Massachusetts. Okay, so we're going to start our show. So if you're listening on the radio and you're wondering why is she yelling all these names and what the hell is happening, here's what we do. We go live on the radio. And my show is I like to interview creative people and talk about what that's like, the day-to-day of living and thriving as a creative person and all that crazy stuff that happens and, you know, how you stay afloat as a creative, you know, and other different things. So also, though, tonight, especially if you're in Massachusetts, you know all about this. Today is the first day of spring. Hi, Belize Torres. Belize is my sweet friend that works at Mess Hall with me. Oh, my God. Gina Savino, my cousin Gina. Everybody clap. Has joined Gina Savino. That's a great name.
Yeah. Right?
That's a brand. So Gina hasn't been with us for a few weeks because she's been busy, but I'm so glad you're back, Gina. Sean Bernardi has joined us. LJ Temple has joined us. Jay Rivera. Yay. Belize sent us all these beautiful kisses. Thank you. Okay, so what I do here is when we go Facebook Live and our friends check in with us, I like to acknowledge them. And I've always said this, my fortune is in my friendships. Put that on my tombstone. Because I don't have a lot of money, but I have the best friends in the world. Mm-hmm. And we've been having so much fun. Henry and I worked together last night downtown. Mm-hmm. And then and sang and carried on and all that. And we had some crazy people that we dealt with.
True.
Right?
Very true.
And then we drove home together and yapped like little old ladies. Well, I did most of the yapping, I think.
No, we were both at it.
Right? So I wanted Henry to come back on the show. He's been on the show before, maybe, what, 6 months ago? Or
I think it was January, wasn't it?
Maybe it was. But I felt like in that particular show that you were on, I didn't get enough of you. I really did. I was like, when I watched it again, I'm like, oh, I wanted to hear more Henry stuff, like, because you do so many things. Mm-hmm. So it's true. And Henry is back on the show, and he's going to tell us all about what he's doing, and he does a lot. Also, we had another guest that was supposed to be on tonight, and she was supposed to leave tomorrow morning on business, but as you may or may not know, there's a nor'easter coming.
What?
It's the first day of spring today, and this is the third nor'easter in like 4 weeks. So that is coming. So the theme of our show, I have my flannel shirt on tonight. I don't know if you can see it. I have my flannel shirt on tonight. Henry has his red sweatshirt. There it is. And in our studio audience is my friend and research intern, Leo Rodriguez. Leo Rodriguez is here. So Leo is here. He's going to join us. He's doing all the research. Sean Bernardi, I'm at Brandy's working, but I want to stop. But I wanted to stop in. Love you. Oh, Sean, we love you. So Sean's at Brandy's. Are you at Brandy's tonight? He's there till 9, I think. Or he was last night. And you could certainly stop at Brandy's after our show. Brandy's is on East 84th between 2nd and 3rd. Henry and I both sub there.
I'm going to be there Thursday.
What?
Yeah.
I can't believe it. I didn't know that.
I just found out today.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
So Henry, please go see Henry on Thursday night at Brandy's Piano Bar. I love Brandy's Piano Bar. I cannot say enough. Shout out to Jim Lazar, who runs the ship there and is so very nice to everybody. Mm-hmm. Suzanne Mason has joined us. Kathy, hi, Kathy Goubier. She also has her own radio show on Armed Radio. It's called The F Word. So check Kathy out. She's really cool. She's a tough chick like I am. All right, so Henry, so I'm going to let you, do you want to start with what you're doing now? Or you have a lot in the works. I know you have a show coming up. I know you work at different clubs in the city. Mm-hmm. You're always working on a project. You play several instruments. So I'm going to let you start and tell us, because what's happening with Henry these days?
Good question. Right now, and I think this is common for a lot of pianists, March through May is my insanely busy season because there's lots of shows going up. People are auditioning. People are going on vacation or coming into the city for vacation. So I'm just working.
Is that audition season, would you say? March through May?
March through May, everyone's auditioning for like summer programs, you know, summer stock around the country.
Okay.
And then fall is the other audition season and the other busy season. They're all auditioning, you know, just regular shows.
Okay. Let me say hi. William Joseph has joined us. That's my cousin from Massachusetts as well. Marisa and Billy send love. Hello. Joseph Macchia. Hi, everybody. We're talking to Henry Kapersky, and he was just, he's a musical director among so many other things. And he said the busy time for auditions is spring and fall.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you play some of those auditions, obviously, right?
Mm-hmm. I play for auditions. And then lots of people are just putting up their own shows right now. Now that winter's ending, you know, like the holidays is the most busy time of year.
Right.
And it's dead for January and February, for me at least.
That's true. For a lot of people, I think. A lot of people just regroup. Plus, you spend so much money during the holidays, whether it's going to parties, buying gifts. I go to a lot of shows. I like holiday shows. And so I tend to spend a lot of money at the holidays. And then January and February, I'm kind of freaking the hell out.
Right.
So, right? And we don't spend as much.
Yeah, we're hibernating financially. And everyone's doing diets for the new year. And
well, not me. Not so much me. I mean, I think I'll try like for 2 days. I'm awful, you guys. I'm the worst. I'm the worst.
No.
Susan Gregory has joined us. Janet Betta has joined us. Janine Molinari has joined us. Janine was on our show last week with Dance Molinari. Look up Dance Molinari. Leo is doing it. By the way, Leo is in our studio audience. Leo Rodriguez, he's come up. I had extra ravioli tonight. That is what our food is. I'll talk about that. And I called him. I'm like, Leo, come on up. There's extra ravioli. And
come for the combo, stay for the food.
That's it. And he is now hanging out in the wings waiting for the ravioli. So, all right, Henry, so what does that mean? Like, what's a day of auditions like for you? Like, what time does it start? And you just, people bring in their music and you just play it? And
Yeah, most of the time. It depends what kind of audition. A lot of the time I get there at 9 a.m. And yet people, sometimes if it's like an open call, people come in, they sing their 16-bar cut, and then they're done. Like, I see someone for a minute.
That's
and
it.
We'll see like 200 people in one day. And it's just...
Wow.
But it flies by because your brain is just working so
hard. So you're literally people... Hi, Isabella Ruskowski. She's just joined us. So people will come in, you're the audition pianist, and they just put stuff in front of you, and you just play. So you're sight reading all day long.
And you get like 10 seconds for them to say, okay, this is my tempo, which is the speed that you sing it, and this is, can I get a starting pitch, stuff like that. And
right,
just
right.
Do it.
Oh boy, that's a hectic day.
What's the most popular song?
Most popular. Oh, I mean, each audition's different. Like, if you're auditioning for an old, like, Rodgers and Hammerstein show, then, you know, everyone's going to sing something from Carousel. And then if you're auditioning for, you know, Rock of Ages, everyone's going to sing, like, a Pat Benatar song. So there isn't really a most popular song for auditions.
And by the way, Leo Rodriguez, you are an intern. You should be shouting from the wings. He's so unruly. Oh, my God. This is What's the Story with Maria, and that was the story with Rodriguez. Oh, my God. He is really... Yes, Julie Cesari has joined us. Let me see. I want to see what Isabella said. Hi, Pia. I hijacked Isabella's Facebook while she is... Oh, my God. Look what's happening here. Julie is enjoying the show. You look great. Oh, Julie. Oh, by the way, I want to talk about this because a lot of people, as of late, have been saying that I look really good, and I thank you because God knows a girl could use a compliment at any point in time, as can a guy. Compliments are great.
Yeah.
And I want to tell you that some of you know and some of you don't know, and I'll just all use this time as a plug. I sell Rodan and Fields skincare, not because of any other reason other than I want to sell it because I love it, because I use it, and I sell it because I get a discount when I sell it, and my friends are happy because they get wonderful products, and they jump on board. So I want to talk about, because I'm focusing on the guys tonight. A lot of times my guy friends, so I use great other products, but this is the line for men. Okay. This is called Beyond the Shave. All right. This is a wonderful product a lot of guys ask me about. This one is when you're shaving, you put this on, it brings down, it's called Unblemish, it brings down all the bumps in your face, and then you shave with this. Now it's brought down all that, and then you throw on the Soothe Number 2 treatment, okay, for sensitive skin. This is going to cool your skin down, and then you're going to put on this delicious moisturizer with SPF. It's got SPF 30 that you go out and you enjoy your day. So, gentlemen, that was dedicated to you tonight. My skincare promo was dedicated to the boys out there. All right, so Henry, you're doing a lot of that. And what? No wonder you get tired working at night as well. See, we were talking about this earlier. We live in these crazy worlds where you're working days and you're working nights, and sometimes you're going from your night job to your day job because you have to take as much work as you can.
Right.
And you're like a zombie, right?
Yeah.
When do you sleep? When do you like to sleep?
If
you had your way.
If I had my way, I would be in bed around 12:30 and waking up at 9:30.
Oh,
I would
okay.
love to do that. But that never, rarely happens.
I don't remember the last time I did that.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. It's
so
crazy.
Yeah, I'm usually in bed by like 2 a.m. and then still getting up around 10 a.m. But then when we work at the piano bar, it's much later. And like
I went
to bed at 5:15 last night.
Me too. I think I went to bed at 7 a.m. this morning. Yes, because by the time I find a parking space, and then I always have to eat, of course, when I get home, because God forbid I don't eat before I go to bed so that I can maintain my girlish figure.
Sure.
Yeah. So then I usually don't like to sleep past noon because I feel like the day's wasted.
I was gonna say, I called you, or I texted you at 12:30 and you responded.
Yeah,
so
no.
So you only got a couple, like 4 or 5 hours of sleep.
That's usually what I get. I usually get about 4 or 5 hours sleep. And then I try to take naps. Like I did a bunch of stuff today. I had to get the apartment ready for the show and I had to cook and stuff. And then I had something to go to at 6 o'clock. So I was on the east side at 6. And then I came home and here I am now. So that's the kind of stuff that happens sometimes. Oh my God, someone has snuck in the door.
No.
Oh, you see, they take over. It's Billy Goffey, everybody. Go speak to the intern and sign in. Hi, Billy Goffey. I invited Bill Gottfried because I had extra.
I think he had plenty of beauty.
Oh, very nice. Thank you, Bill.
As evening goes on, accent changes.
Oh, all right. Very good.
That's the problem with moose and squirrel.
All right, Billy.
Wearing
he has joined us.
Ironic old shirt.
Oh, I love it. And you have the suspenders. Wow.
Shirt still works with him.
How retro.
It's young and beautiful.
Yes,
all right, leave him alone. Leave him alone. Go right. Sit down, Billy.
You're beautiful too.
Leo, you're in charge. Oh, my God. I know. We got to check them at the door.
Okay.
All right. So I've invited the crazies over tonight because I had extra food.
Leo's spanking me.
All right. Keep it down, boys. Keep it down. Okay, so we are, we're talking about auditions, and then we're talking about working different crazy hours and what that ends up meaning. And also now I want to talk about, you have a show coming up, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay, so please tell us about that, because we want to make sure people know about it and get tickets to it.
Okay, it's March 31st at 9:30 p.m. It's a Saturday at the good old duplex on Christopher Street in 7th Ave.
Okay.
And I'm really
How do they get
it.
Tickets?
You can get tickets on my website at henrykopersky.com/halopop.
Oh, wow.
Leo has put the link in the comments.
Leo's our research intern. I don't know. Okay. Dance Molinari has, Leo, put that up. And then if you scroll down, he has put up the link to Henry's show.
Mm-hmm. I'm really proud of it. And I think it's I think anyone can enjoy it. It's about music. It's not like a show about me, which shows about people are great, but it's not like my story.
So what is the show about? Because I have no idea what the show is about.
It's all about kind of like existence and how music fits into that. What music is, like how music is the same thing as just energy or love, and how it affects us. And, yeah, it is. We can communicate with music as a language. Or like,
do you have other singers joining you, or is it just you?
No, it's just me and a piano. That's
wow.
The whole show.
And how much are the tickets?
Tickets are $10 if you buy them in advance online, and
on
they're
Purple
15 at the door.
Okay, great. So you want to go see, tell us the date of your show again.
It's Saturday, March 31st.
Okay.
At 9:30. It's Passover.
Oh, well, you know what?
So bring the challah.
Mm-hmm. Bring the challah bread. Yes, there will be challah bread afterwards. But also, isn't Passover have a meaning of like, there's a spiritual, of course,
oh,
it's a
no,
spiritual
it makes
holiday.
A lot of sense.
But did you do that on purpose?
No, I just wasn't thinking. Easter is the next day, of course, and there's a lot of, I wanted this show to like help people feel reborn, you know, and
of course.
Easter is a,
Easter,
I mean, it's coming back from the dead, but it's similar rebirth and like.
Well, I just call Easter the greatest comeback of all time.
Yeah,
I mean,
the phoenix rising from the ashes.
Right. Wow. Thank you for getting that. Thank you for getting that, Leo. So Tony Patelis has joined us. He was on the show last week. Thomas Crosby has joined us. Gina Savino says beautiful. Oh, thank you, Gina. I hope that I don't know if that's for me or Henry, but Henry's pretty beautiful himself. Maybe it was about Billy Goffey's suspenders. It could have been. Josephino has joined us. Angela, I love you too, sweetheart. All these great people. Now, I want to talk about, you grew up in Detroit, right?
No, Grand Rapids. Very different.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Detroit is, you know, a major city. And Grand Rapids, it's a bit smaller, and it's not diverse at all. It's very white bread.
Excuse me, did you want... is there something you want to say? Because we're in the middle of the show here, guys. And there's chatting on the side.
From the interns.
Oh, my God, from the interns. We are trying. Did you have a few drinks or something? Did you hit the sauce? Oh, my God, he hit the sauce. I'm telling you.
I hit the tomato sauce.
I am interviewing Henry Kopersky. Oh, my God. You see what happens when you have a studio audience. All right, so Grand Rapids is very different than...
Yeah, it's really, like, very... Protestant, white, middle class to upper middle class city. Whereas Detroit is extremely diverse in all, every way.
Okay, now, speaking of family and all these, we talked about this earlier. I want to talk about the fact that you and your brothers are also musical. You're very musical. And I want to talk about the fact that you and your brothers all play instruments, right? So let's talk about that.
Yeah, my youngest brother is a really great singer. I wish I could sing like him. And my middle brother is a good singer, too.
You've always said that about your brother. You wish you could sing like him. What does he sound like?
He has a very deep, like, bass or low baritone voice. He can sing like Michael Bublé really well.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's got a great voice. And he can also do like classical stuff, like which I cannot do at all.
Wow.
So I'm a little jealous.
And what was it like growing up? Now, your mother's very musical, right?
My mother's the most musical of us all. She's a classically trained opera singer.
Wow.
And she teaches voice at a college in Michigan. And she's also an amazing
What's the college? Pianist. Is it okay to say?
Yeah, she teaches at Hope College, which is in Holland, Michigan.
Okay, so shout out to your mom.
Yeah, she's amazing. She's one the best singer I know, and she's an incredible pianist, like way better than me. Like, she's so good. I always feel guilty for, like, being born. I'm like, Mom, you should have moved to New York. And
oh, Henry, you see, that's why I love you. I always say that if I had a son, I would like him to be like Henry, not
that's
like Billy or...
So nice.
Well, Leo's nice. I like, but Billy's so much work. So that you, so you felt a little bit of guilt because you felt like you... Were you the firstborn?
Yeah, I'm the oldest.
Okay, and she would have gone in... You think she would have moved to New York?
I don't know if she... Would have, and she says she's, you know, she wanted kids and whatnot, but she still works as a performer, and it's getting harder as she gets older, to, you know, keep up with the different ways that you promote and book gigs and whatever.
Yeah, it's a self-promoting business.
Right.
It's a lot. It's hard.
And she's also in Michigan, which there's not as much going on. I'm like, oh, if she lived in New York, she could do, there'd be work, you know.
That's what it is. Well, where does one perform when you're out there?
She performs
as an opera singer.
The symphony orchestras it in various, like...
That's a really big deal.
Yeah, it's great. And she performs with symphonies all over the country. And she's got performed with orchestras in Europe. Like, she travels a lot.
Wow!
So,
so she must be really good.
She's amazing, yeah.
And yeah.
She's so...
And what's her name?
Diane Penning.
Diane Penning. Okay. Mm-hmm. Is Henry's mom, and she's an opera singer, so shout out to Diane Penning.
She's my favorite person in the whole world.
Diane, also so you know, because Henry and I, sometimes I drive him home, or we're just hanging out and talking at work, and he absolutely adores you and has always spoken of you in the highest regard. And I love, you know, I always say this to my friends, my straight women friends that date guys, and they're like, oh, I met this guy, and I'm like, here's how you know if a guy's... Great. Or if you're a gay guy and you're dating a gay guy, and here's how you tell if a man is a really good man. On the first date, how does he talk about his mother and his sisters or his family in general, and how does he treat the waitress or the bartender?
Mm.
That's all you need to know.
Yes.
If this person can pass the test on the first date of how he treats that group of people, that's a winner.
That's so true.
And I'm telling you, Henry, since day one, you've always spoken so highly of your mom, which makes me, as a woman that's probably your mom's age, feel like, wow, then, you know, he looks at me in a respectful way as well, because that's, you know, sometimes with young people, it doesn't always happen that way.
Mm-hmm.
But I have a lot of respect for that. So your show's coming. Now, you also work at Club Coming, right, which is a new club. Tell us about that.
Yeah, it opened. There's a club in the East Village on 6th Street and Avenue A. It opened in September. It used to be Eastern Bloc, which was a terrifying gay bar that was like...
Eastern Bloc?
Russia-themed or something.
Oh, my God. Can you imagine? That's like an oxymoron.
Scary. Yeah. I'd been a few times, but it was fun. But now, Alan Cumming has turned it into his own
club. Alan Cumming, famous Alan Cumming.
Yeah.
Of
X-Men.
Yeah, and Cabaret and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Broadway. He's done a bunch of Broadway. Didn't he also do Three Penny Opera?
I don't know.
I don't know why I think he did.
And
but
he has his own CBS show now where he plays like a detective, and that just premiered on Sunday.
Yes, and one of our guests on our show, Heidi, Jermaine Schnappoff, who is a stunt woman, does stunt work on that show.
Oh, cool.
And she said that he's so nice.
Yeah, he is.
So you've met him, and he owns the club. He's one of the owners of the club.
Yeah.
And I don't know much about this club, but I've just been seeing people post about it and go to it. It's different than the piano bars. I know that.
Mm-hmm.
So there are shows there every night that happen?
Yeah, there are multiple shows, usually like 3 shows a night.
Wow.
Starting at like 7 and then 9 and then 11. And then it's open till... Yeah, 4-ish.
And then people just kind of hang out and party.
Yeah, and they always have a great crowd. And I'll tell you, it's because everyone that works there is so nice, and that's important. Like, there are 4 owners, and I know all of them, and they all talk about how important it is that their staff is extremely kind to all the patrons. And so when there's that, you know, foundation, nice people come in. Right. Every time I go there, it's just such a great experience.
I'm dying to go. I have to go on a night that you work, and you're there on Wednesday nights, right?
Every Wednesday at 8, I do a comedy show there with my writing partner, Catherine. And then starting in April at 10 p.m. on every Wednesday, I'm going to be hosting my own open mic there.
Wednesdays at 10?
Wednesdays at 10 in April.
And wow. Hopefully, and beyond.
And beyond.
Okay.
Like a music theater or anything. Music open mic.
So you want to go and see Henry Kapersky at his show. You want to go see him at Club Coming. And you're filling in at Brandy's on Thursday, right?
Yes. And I believe I'll be there a lot of Thursdays this summer.
Wow. Okay, good to know. All right. So there's a lot of things happening, and you're going to be juggling a lot of things. You're not doing any cruise ships or anything like that, right?
No, but I would like
A lot of people do a lot of cruise ships. And yeah. That takes a lot of piano players out of town for like 2 weeks at a time, a month at a time. I know Nate Lucieri has been in, I think, Puerto Vallarta now for a few months and will continue to be for a few months. So, you know, that's the thing about you move to New York, you're an artist of some sort, and if you're in the music business, I know especially, there are different things that you do that would move you around, but especially I think as a musical director, you can get a lot of work. You come here, this is your base. And then you can move around a lot.
Yeah.
So would you prefer to stay kind of local, or do you like to travel around?
Traveling is my absolute favorite thing in the world.
Really?
Yeah. And so it's tricky with New York because it's so expensive to live here, but it's the cheapest place to travel from.
Is that true? I didn't know that.
But yeah.
Why is that?
Because, you know, the JFK and LaGuardia and Newark too, they're all just such huge airports. There are plenty of cheap flights to anywhere.
Wow.
Like if you try to fly, when I go from Grand Rapids, you know, it's going to cost like $1,500 to $2,000 to get somewhere in Europe. But from JFK, you can get to London for $150.
Really?
Yeah. And then even there are deals. I'm obsessed with traveling. So every night I go on Google Flights and just explore.
You know, Judy Mace is like that. She was going to maybe be here tonight, but she has so much going on. Gina Savino said, he's so cute. I know.
Thanks, Gina. I love your name.
Oh, my God. She has a beautiful name, right? Gina. And she's like a total hottie. She and her sister are hairdressers. And it's Joyce's Unisex Salon, 132 Ferry Street, Everett, Massachusetts. I want to give a shout out to my cousin Angela was on. She owns a shop in Melrose. And Angela, I'm forgetting, I think it's Studio 768. Is that maybe you could type in Melrose, Massachusetts? And my sister has a salon, European Flair, 1210 Main Street and West Concord, Massachusetts. My cousin Nicole has Nicole's Salon and Day Spa, Main Street and Stoneham. So there's a lot of my cousins are in the hair business and beauty business and all that. So Gina knows cute. She knows aesthetics. And she says, Henry's so cute. I agree, Gina. I agree. All right, so Andy Prasky has joined us. Oh, Billy Goffey's joined us.
Yes.
Darcy Blakesley, hi, Darcy.
Hi, Darcy.
Isabella, how are you? Henry's adorable. Isabella's my cousin, too. I know, everybody thinks Henry's so cute, and he is. Okay, what did you say, Billy? Thank you, Gina, from one of the, interns.
She loves the interns.
Oh, yeah, the interns are fabulous. Sue Varin has joined us. Sue Varin, I was Facebooking with her today. I want to get her on the show. She's an amazing actress. She just won an award, and she's constantly working. Richard Portis has joined us. Everybody clap for Richard Portis.
Yay, yay.
Richard Portis is my knight in shining armor out there on Facebook. He is always complimenting me, and he is Lynn Portis, is one of my favorite people and best friends and my musical director. It's her dad, and we love Lynn. And Richard, hello, my love. Eric Eves Garcia. Oh, what? The audience is screaming. Well, thank you. Thank you so much. I love applause. You know I love the applause. Kenny Holcomb has joined us. Yes, he did Three Penny Opera. Okay. Thank you, Kenny.
Confirming.
I don't know why I thought that Alan Cumming and Cyndi Lauper, they were both in it. I'm pretty sure of that. And this may be about, Kenny, I'm thinking 8 years ago or something like that, right?
This is on Broadway?
Yes, at the American Airlines Theater.
Wow.
Yeah, and it was supposedly really, really, really good. It was one of those things that kind of like, you know when you say, oh, I'm going to go see that, I'm going to go see it, and then it It's gone.
Oh, every show pretty much.
Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm. You know when I see a lot of shows in the summer because I'm not teaching in the summer.
Is Three Penny Opera, does that have Mac the Knight?
Yeah.
Okay, that's the one thing I know.
Yeah, that's when I see the most shows because, as a matter of fact, tomorrow's a snow day. So, speaking of which, okay, I want to talk about the fact that, and then we'll bring on our interns after we do this part of our show. So, yeah, maybe we'll bring on our interns. Do you mind, Henry, if we bring
Not
on these silly gooses? Come on, guys, and join us. Everybody, Leo Rodriguez and Billy Goffey. Billy Goffey. Oh, my God. Billy Goffey is, lets me know that it's okay. It's all going to work out. Oh, my God. You know who this is calling.
Oh,
it's my cousin, Rena.
Oh,
it's
gosh.
Our weather report. Where is
she?
Lena, Rena, call back, call back. All right, so I'm going to call her. Rena is my cousin from Massachusetts, and I always laugh because this, I always say I know what the weather is like because Rena will post it on her Facebook wall. Here she's calling now. So she said last week, am I your meteorologist? And yes, I have officially... Hi, Rena. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm good. Okay, so Rena Crignali-Berge is officially our new meteorologist now. You are our weather representative, Rena. You know, every good show has a weather person, and you are our weather person because you are always putting beautiful pictures on of the different weather things, and you have a beautiful backyard and a big window. So please tell us there's a northeastern thing coming around the bend.
Oh,
tell us what's happening.
God.
Tell us what's happening in Massachusetts.
There is. So February was pretty mild, so we got all excited for spring, and then Mother Nature came back with a vengeance, and no one's happy about this.
That's right. Mother Nature has come back with a vengeance. What are you guys expecting out there for inches?
So we're getting the morning to even you're getting worse than New York and Boston.
Oh, really?
And everything is being downgraded in the last hour. The second is now that I'm the official meteorologist.
Yes, you are the meteorologist. And I know you did your homework because you're one of those really smart kids. Like, Rena's like the A student that the rest of us were getting arrested, and Rena was like getting straight A's. It's true.
They've been downgrading. So now I'll tell you, New York City is going to get. You're supposed to get 12 to 16 inches.
Yeah. 12 to 16?
7 to 11 inches.
Yeah. We're getting 16.
In the last hour, they downgraded to 7 to 11 inches.
Okay,
because the school I teach at has already closed. They already, everybody got a notification. We're closed tomorrow. So, which means.
There's a winter storm warning in effect.
That's right. But you know what that means? No calories tomorrow. Whatever you eat on a snow day, I just found this out, Rena. I don't know if you know this. Guys, did you know this? Whatever you eat on a snow day has no calories.
That makes so much sense.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
So after this, what I'm going to do before the snow comes, I'm going to fill my gas tank, and I'm going to the supermarket to buy as much junk food as I can because you have to eat it before the day, you know, before they clean up because it's only during the snow.
Tonight, they might already be cleaned out. Bread, milk, gone.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
Remember that guy? Got to get the bread and milk. There's a very funny meme about a Massachusetts guy. Got to get the bread and milk because everybody freaks out. Yeah, what is it about the bread and milk?
Italians who have soft pantries. They don't have to worry about running out for the bread and milk.
I'm so glad you talked about that because Rena and I know her mother and my mother are sisters. And we, as Italian kids, always had stocked basements, mm-hmm. pantries. Mm-hmm. And Rena, I want you to talk about the fact that your family always make those tomatoes in the summertime. What do they do?
Oh, my gosh. Yes, we dry the tomatoes in August.
So you
the tomatoes are really ripe and fresh. We get them at the farm, and we process them, put them in jars for the winter.
And you still have any left? It lasts how long, the whole winter?
It does. Actually, last year was a bad topic. We didn't do it last year, so almost everybody in the family is out, except for me and Ron. We're hoarding a couple of them.
Do it. Don't give it up. Don't give it up. Ron is her husband. Don't give it up. Oh, no. You know what's going to happen. Your brothers are going to probably be driving over there as we speak. They're gonna,
exactly.
You know how your brothers are, especially Ronnie, her cousin Ronaldo.
Yeah, so we'll take the plumbing incident. Money will come over. Robbie will help to do something with the wood, and there goes my job.
That's what happens. Her brothers are going to pretend that they're doing work around the house, and the jars will be gone. I'm telling you, that's how Italian kids roll. All right. Well, so listen. So we can expect it to start snowing when?
It's supposed to start tomorrow morning, 6 a.m.
6 a.m. Oh, Jesus. All right.
It's going to be icy.
Oh,
and
no.
It's going to go into Thursday. So tomorrow's the worst day for you guys. In Boston, we're down to like 3 inches, maybe even less.
That's it. Downgraded. Well, thank God, because my poor dad, I always worry about my dad out there snowblowing. He's got that crazy snowblower. You can't get him off that. He's always like, no, I'm fine. He's 82. I don't.
Oh, my God, bless him.
No, but he's out there. He's out there. And then his neighbor, shout out to my dad's neighbor. He's a firefighter next door, and he always plows my dad's, he helps out. So one thing I want to talk about, well, Stone and the Massachusetts, I don't know if it's like this out here, but neighbors really, really, really help each other out. So a big round of applause for our neighbors. Rena, I can't thank you enough. You are now our official meteorologist. I don't know if you know
Yay!
That. Yes, Rena Crugnali-Berge. And her husband is a mail carrier. He works for the post office. Not a mail carrier.
That's why he's obsessed with the weather, because he's out in it all day. I'm inside, and I just say, oh, it looks so pretty.
Right, it looks so pretty. And he's like, all these swear words are coming out of his head.
Snow, right?
All right. Well, that's right. What's the mailman thing, Leo? Through sleet?
Rain, or was it sleet, sun, rain, snow?
Whatever it is, Nor, whatever will stop us from our...
No roosters.
We're going to have to... Leo, look that up. He's our research assistant.
Yeah, get on that.
It's on the post office in New York. Get on it. Leo's our research assistant. Yes. Find out, and that will dedicate that to Ron Berge, our mail carrier for tomorrow. All right, thank you, Rena Crugnali. Give us everybody big hand for Rena Crugnali, my cousin, our meteorologist. Thank you, Rena. I love you very much, and I'll see you in a few weeks. I'm coming home.
All right,
bye, honey. Beautiful. All right, Rena Crugnali, my cousin, has called in. Okay, did you get it? Neither rain?
Nor hail, nor sleet, nor
snow. Okay, come up here and say it louder, Billy.
This courier from his appointed rounds. And I knew that without the Google.
Did you really? Say it again, Bill. Say it again. This is for all the mailmen out there.
Did I get it right?
Say it, Billy. Billy, he's senile. He goes up.
Who's senile?
You go up. We're live, Billy.
Glittery thing in the corner.
We're live, Billy.
Nor hail, nor sleep, nor snow shall keep this courier from its appointed round.
Okay, wow. Thank you
close,
so much.
Close. Close.
That's the post
office. What was yours, Leo?
You have the post office, right?
You know what?
Neither snow nor rain nor heat nor gloom or gloom of night.
Gloom of night.
Save these couriers from the swift completion of their appointed round.
The swift completion.
Wow. Not the swift. Well, he's got an ARP card as to why we're not as swift as we used to be. All right. So listen, this. We're going to start adding weather to the show. So the name of that part of our show is What's the Story with the Friggin' Weather? That's it. That's our new, and there's a lot happening. It's the first day of spring, and what's the story with the Friggin' Weather? Let's check in with our friends. Let me see what's happening. So Isabella says, Alan Cumming is Circle of Friends with Minnie Driver. Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Susie Turgeon has joined us. Let me see. Brendan Doherty has joined us. Now, Brendan Ryan joined us a while back. He is a captain, NYPD. I salute you, sir. He is my friend. He plays the bagpipes. Brendan,
cool.
I know. I want to get Brendan on the show. Jill Anderson has joined us. Gerardo Garcia has joined us. He's in Mexico. Hi, Gerardo. Leo is Mexican. And you would like each other. You guys are really... He's wonderful, and Leo is wonderful. When he comes to town, let us know, Gerardo, and we'll all hang out downtown. All right, Jill Anderson, how are you, sweetheart? Good to see you.
I think I saw Rachel.
Oh, Isabella is Marisa. I see, Gina, what you're saying. So my cousin Gina said that Isabella is really Marisa is her mom. She's hijacked. Oh, I see now.
Yeah.
Sabah has joined us. Lydia Stuckey, what? Lydia, where have you been? I haven't seen you in ages. She is amazing. Costume designer, and oh boy, she used to make the costumes for Tony and Tina's wedding back in the day, but she does a million things. Lydia, I would love, if you're ever in town, to have you on the show. Daka Mohammed has joined us. Daka, you know Daka from downtown.
Remember Daka?
Yes, you know Daka.
Yeah.
Rachel Gavaletz has joined us.
Yay.
All right. Every good Italian has multiple cans of olive oil in the basement, too. Thank you, Marisa, my cousin Marisa.
Excuse me, Miss Hostess. It's to be nice to the old man.
Oh, no.
That would be me.
That would be me. Now, Marisa was on the show the day after Christmas, called in with recipes, Christmas recipes.
Thanks.
Marisa, you're going to love this. So tonight, my food, we reached the part of our show called Go ahead. Keep eating. All right, so tonight I have spinach and cheese ravioli. Mm-hmm. And if that wasn't enough, I made a chicken. I chopped up some chicken, sauteed it with garlic, onions, broccoli, and all kinds of seasoning. And then put some cream in there, delicious half and half, and butter, because I needed more calories in that dish. And some pepper, black pepper. So that's what we're having tonight. That is our display plate. And then for cookies, our cookies tonight, or well, our dessert tonight, are lemon cream ginger cookies. So this is ginger cookie with lemon cream inside. I love ginger. And so that's what's happening for cookies tonight.
I can't wait.
Yes, and the plate I have it on says cookies for Santa. You know why? Because of the snow. And you see, Leo is wearing his red.
Get you red your sweater.
He had a sweater. I am wearing a flannel tonight because the nor'easter is coming.
And Bill looks like Jack Frost.
Or as they say in Boston, the nor'easter. There's a goddamn nor'easter coming down. Get the shovels out. Get the snow blower. All right, so Leo, thank you for joining us tonight. Now, I do want to, all joking aside, every week Leo joins us and does research for us and posts everybody's websites and all that stuff. So I do want to thank him very much. Thank you, Leo. You are fabulous.
It's important to get everybody's information for you out there.
It's true, but I can't do it while I'm, because tonight we had like a false start. We had all that stuff. Roberta MacGyver has joined us. Hi, Roberta. Okay, so Rena Cunyali Berge says, mail carrier Ron says, let's read it straight from the mailman's mouth.
Okay.
Neither snow nor rain nor heat nor gloom of night stays these couriers from their swift completion of their appointed rounds.
Wow.
Leo researched that and you were correct. Billy, you wrong. Remembered almost all of that.
Bill was wrong.
How did you know that, though? How did you remember that, Bill? You like that stuff.
I follow this useless stuff. And it's usually wrong.
Well, it was pretty close, I'll tell you.
Yeah. Let's give him the test, though. What's your name?
No, he doesn't know. He doesn't know what year it is, all that stuff. Pretty soon, what are we going to do with it? We're going to have to put him in a home soon. I don't want to be responsible. Although, if he's missing for days, I have keys to his apartment. That's all I know. Just for the love of God, please. I have so much on my plate. I don't need that, too. So stay healthy. All right, so let me see. What do I want to talk about now? We have about 15 minutes left to our show. So all of us are musicians, and all of us are, oh my God, Bill, you know what you should do? Grab the guitar.
And?
I don't know if it, we should just do a song.
Okay, yeah.
We should quickly do a song. That would be so much.
Hold on.
We could do Home.
Home,
yeah.
That's what I said.
I think it's oh my God, Bill Gothy, crazy as he is a mean musician.
Yes,
he's a mean musician.
He's mean.
It's that one, sweetheart. It's the first one.
He's mean, all right.
Yeah, the one with the big, with the better. Yeah, I believe that's it. So, now, Henry, while we're talking about instruments, you play. Tell us about the instruments you play and when you picked them up. Like, what was first?
Oh, the first instrument I played was the piano.
Because your mom, right?
Yeah. And then I picked up clarinet for school.
I didn't know you played the clarinet.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
But then I switched to the saxophone.
Now, when people say picked up, because I know a lot of my friends have kids that they're in band and things like that.
Yeah.
When you go into bands, like when the first time as a kid, do they just have a room full of instruments and you go and choose the one you want?
Yeah, you get to try it out and to see what works for you. Like, I cannot make my lips buzz for like a brass instrument, so I couldn't play trumpet or trombone.
Oh, so that's something you have to be able to do.
Yeah, I can do it for a few seconds, but then it's done.
Well, you know, it's funny with like teaching voice, that's one of the things that we work on, lip rolls.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and it's so funny because some of the students will be like, I don't want to do this, but it's so important to be able to get your vocal cords ready and your lips ready. And it seems crazy, but lip rolls are really big.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I guess if you were a horn player, that's important.
Yeah, it's like, I can't do it.
Wow, okay.
So she's a disease.
Have to be able to fill with air. I have I want to invite them on. My friend Jamie Dauber is an incredible trumpet player. Incredible. Mm. She's in a band called Diva Jazz Orchestra. And she also played on my CD. She played in the Amputated Skyline.
Oh,
that's
cool.
Her playing the trumpet.
Oh,
she actually wrote that whole line. Like that. Like in the studio. So I want to have Jamie on. But Jamie is one of those people. One year I was putting together a softball team. And I said, Jamie, you want to play? She said, I love softball, but I'm afraid if I get hit,
Oh, yeah.
Then I won't be able to. And I didn't understand it at the time, but now it makes sense.
Yeah, my family is really into volleyball. Like, every summer we'd like,
I love it. I love sports. Volleyball.
And I stopped a couple of years ago because I was like, oh, if I, like, hurt my hand with once, like, I won't be able to play the duplex or anywhere, like, for, you know, a couple of weeks.
Wow, so it's true. It's true. Things like that, you don't think about it as much. All right, so I think Leo is fabulous. Gina Savino said Leo is fabulous. You know what, Gina? I swear to God, I want you to come visit me so badly.
And yeah.
Because you would love my friends and they would love you. Gina and Joyce are party girls. And Marisa, Gina, Joyce, I think the three of you in this apartment jammed in with all my crazy friends. And then another time we'll have my other cousins.
Well,
so,
I didn't canvas for that one.
Yeah, that's a whole different thing. But you guys would love each other. Leo and Gina, oh my God, that would be crazy.
Get my hair done up there.
Actually, they're amazing hairdressers. Why don't we do a road trip?
Oh my gosh, I'm in.
Why don't we do a road trip to Joyce's unisex salon?
I'm buying anything.
No, I'm serious. We can just either we can pile in my car, which is a small car, or we can rent one. Just go down there, and we'll do What's the Story with Maria live.
In the salon.
Oh,
that'd be fun.
Well, Joe Savino gets his hair done there, so I know Joe Savino. He might be jealous if I go down there.
I see hearts.
I'm telling you, Gina, we have to plan
this.
That'd
be fun.
We have to plan this. All right, so Leo, let's all do it. We're all going to sing, because I'm in the movie. We have all these great musicians. We have 10 minutes left. Should we do the song Home? Are you feeling that? You'll know as soon as it starts.
Oh. If you want to play Home.
You know what? All right, you guys started. You guys started. I'm going to get my drums. Hold on a second.
Okay, so now you're putting me in front of a live microphone.
Yeah, no, I'm going to get my drums.
You're putting me in front of a live microphone.
She's straight. I think what we can be doing is that we should be sharing this with everybody and try to get as many viewers as we can at the top for each show and see how many times you get. See that little dot up there where it says 8 on the corner of your screen?
Yes.
Right? It says 8. So there's like, oh, damn.
Whenever you're ready, we're gonna do. I always love when we do little musical shows.
Got it.
He's so talented for a crazy person, right? You want to start it, or shall I start it? And then you take the second voice.
All right.
Hold on to me as we go. As we roll down this unfamiliar road. I know this wave is stringing us along. No, you're not alone. I wanna make this place your own. Girl, it'll all be clear. Don't be no mind to the demons they fill you with fear. The troubles they may drag you down. If you get lost, you can always be found. No, you're not alone. I'm gonna make this place your own. And we'll go on with this.
Ooh.
next, did you?
No,
I next know. Time. Next time. Listen.
Or Korean or
what I oh, Billy, that was wonderful. Isn't yeah, Billy talented? Yeah. So, Billy Goffey. Oh my God, he really is so talented.
So good for your age.
And he can cook really well. He made these delicious, delicious, delicious. Oh my God, Rena said if we take a road trip to Boston, she'll make sauce. Oh, oh my God, that's it.
Oh, that's by the way, for his desserts, we got to start calling him Biscoffies.
You know what? I think you got something there. And sounds great.
Thank you, Rachel.
Thank you, Rachel. That is a great idea. So Bill's name is Bill Goffey, G-O-F-F-I, right? Mm-hmm. And he makes amazing biscotti. And we always are like, Bill, you should sell your biscotti. You should sell. And so he does. He makes batches. And he'll ship them anywhere, by the way. They're delicious.
Have Bill Biscoffey with your coffee.
That's really good, Leo. So Biscoffey, B-I-S-G-O-F-F-I. That is no joke.
I like that lavender flavor you made.
Yeah. And the M&M ones.
That's my flavor.
With the chocolate, right?
The white chocolate.
Are you making an Easter batch? Oh, wait, Marisa, you know Marisa's dad, who's my Uncle John, my mom's brother, was a baker, an amazing baker. Do you know what Billy makes that your dad used to make?
Those things.
The eggs in the bread. Oh, he braids the bread and puts the eggs in and cooks it. And you're the only other person besides my Uncle John that's ever done that I knew of. Do you guys grow up with that at all? Do you know what that is?
He's very not Italian.
Well, that's okay. We need Italian. Look at the diverse group here. We have two Italians. We have a Mexican. And what are you? German?
German, Dutch, Polish.
Polish. Okay. So
bread like that for Easter of some sort. Because I know Mexicans have it as well.
So Easter is coming up. What do we talk about? We have about 5 minutes left.
I'm April 1st. He's not going to show up.
Jesus. Listen to me. First of all, the Easter Bunny comes first. He shows up at CVS. And then you have to go through the whole that weekend of sadness. Mm-hmm. And that's it. And then, as I've said before, the greatest comeback of all time. Goodbye. Jesus just appears again. And that's it. You don't have to. I mean, we get sad every year, but you don't have to get sad because then all great things happen.
Wait a minute. It's April 1st. What if he actually does appear this time?
What? What do you mean?
It's April 1st. Easter's on April 1st this year.
Are they on Groundhog Day?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you mean it's April Fool's Day.
It's April Fool's Day. So why don't you say Fool's
Day? Wait, oh, wow.
I never thought of that. I'd be in trouble.
Wait, so April Fool's Day and Easter on the same day this year?
Wow.
That is complicated.
Nobody better be messing with my baskets.
Oh, listen, that's another show. Penny James has joined us. Steve Isaacson has joined us. Oh, my God. Jerry does it, too. Jerry does what? What does Jerry do?
The bread.
Her brother Jerry, who actually is also a baker, and I think John, too. And also, Jerry travels all around. He's been to New York, and he's like kind of like, you know how Alton, what's that, the scientist, yes.
Oh, no.
Jerry's kind of like a scientist, too, like when the bread, like he'll go to different companies and help them. With make their own bread.
Alton Brown.
If I were to open up, which I want to do, one of my dreams, I'm putting it out there, I want to open up my own place that has piano bar and pizza and delicious Italian food.
Well, I know a good pizza maker.
Yes, I know. I know.
And
then
tacos.
I know. And then Jerry, I'm going to have my cousin Jerry come and design the brick oven. Because he knows about this stuff. And then design that whole thing, all about the pizzas. And then Billy, you are my chief pizza maker. Billy makes the most amazing pizzas, and Jerry knows his stuff. You guys would get along great.
I'm making a brick oven.
You are making a brick oven?
Joshua's cabin.
Really?
Ooh. Shout out.
Well, yeah, where's that restaurant? Tell us about that restaurant.
Lost Dog Cafe.
Lost Dog Cafe.
In Binghamton, New York. It's exactly 3 hours from here.
Hi, Josh.
And Josh is now the head chef over there.
Ooh, I saw the little article.
Oh, the pizza cana. Marisa said the pizza cana. You make that, right? You make the pizza again? Oh my God, there's so much we're going to do. Marisa, I feel like a new surge of all these things we're going to do. So, Henry, you guys celebrate Easter, your family celebrates Easter, and you're a real spiritual guy. You've been doing a lot of podcasts and stuff too, and they are of spiritual nature, right?
Yeah.
So, how can people find that? Because you go live a lot. Should they just become your Facebook friend?
Yeah. You can follow me. Find Henry Kapersky. You can follow me.
Follow Henry Kapersky. Spell your last name, Henry, for our radio listeners.
K-O-P-E-R-S-K-I.
Okay, that's Henry Kapersky, and I've often watched, and it's like you just feel like you took a sedative. You watch; it's very calming, and boy, could we use that. So you want to follow Henry. He does so many wonderful things. And I'm just crazy about you, Henry. I'm so glad you came on the show.
Oh, thank you. I love you, too. Right. Thank you so much.
And these two
me.
Rascally rabbits.
Yeah, what?
Leo, I want to thank you. Every week, Leo comes on our show. And he look. We're not talking to you right now, Billy. He's always, oh, my God.
I'm doing my job.
So thank you for being our research intern. Bill Goffey is our guitar player.
Is it my turn now?
Yes, now it's your turn. Bill Goffey, you can check out Bill Goffey downtown at the Duplex on between like 6 and 8 o'clock on Thursday, happy hour. He plays 6 and 9. Plays happy hour. And it's okay, I think we got to go, right, Jimmy?
Uh-oh.
How much time we got, Jimmy?
20 seconds.
20 seconds. Okay, everybody, thank you to all my cousins in Boston. Thank you, Rena, for calling in. We're going to do a Boston road trip. And let's finish out with home. Thank you. We love you. Come back every Tuesday at 9. Thanks, Jimmy.